Well, it's just great to see all of the people you meet over the years, the regulars at Fright Fest, but it's also one of the places where people from the industry will be here. You know, and it's great to, this year especially, Barbara and Ted came over with We're Still Here, and you know, I know Barbara Crampton and Ted Geoghegan from the US convention circuit, and we've become friends there, and so it's great to see friends from abroad and to make new friends. I mean, I really liked the Argentinian film, the Rotten Link, and the director from that is just amazing. He's a great laugh. So, okay, it's about a guy that has an imaginary friend, or had one in childhood, and then he's working in an office environment that's full of bullies. He witnesses a colleague get bullied to a tragic consequence, and that's my character. So I get picked on a lot, and as you'll see, and then that triggers off the main character's spiral into madness, and him becoming reacquainted with his imaginary childhood friend again, who's pretty violent. I mean, in Human Centipede 3, I get shot in the head, so it's with them both coming out fairly close after one another, I'm just this year's shot in the head guy, I think. I think the first Human Centipede film, the idea was so gross, and Tom really sort of captured that, and Dieter's performance just really holds you in there. I think with Human Centipede 2, with Tom responding to the fans, and they're kind of saying it, what the first one wasn't that gory, and Tom going completely OTT with the second one, but keeping it dark and kind of depressing in a way, but keeping the humour in there. I think that's it's become this generation's Texas Chainsaw Massacre, which again has, you know, humour, but it's kind of very dark. I think it's the film a lot of kids and teenagers dare each other to see, you know. I mean, I've had lots of people come up to me pretending to have seen it, and it's, when you talk to them, it's obvious they haven't, but everyone kind of wants to be one of the people that have seen it, so that's good. So,
how do you feel about specifically the censorship debate that the film's variously provoked?
Well, with Human Centipede 2, well, it was interesting because I kind of grew up in the Video Nasties era. You know, I was teen, 11, 12 when it all sort of came about. And it's kind of interesting to go from having a kind of academic interest from growing up with that into actually being at the centre of the storm with Human Centipede 2. So it's kind of interesting to note that I think the thing that caused the most controversy, or that fueled the controversy, was the BBFC press release. I've no problem with the BBFC rejecting or refusing to certificate a film, but I thought the press release went beyond the remit of the BBFC. That's what triggered campaigns in other countries as well. You know, Australia, the Christian group Family Voice Australia wanted to ban the film because of the BBFC press release. So, you know, I think when people say that it's all good publicity, it's not. It's kind of, there's good and bad aspects to it. So,
final question: what else is coming up for you at the moment? Where are we going to see you next?
Hopefully before the end of the year, Bogeyman Reincarnation, with directed by Uli Lamel, and then there's another British low-budget independent film called Dead Love, and then next year the Frankenstein-created Bikers, which I think will be a lot of fun. So keep watching the screens.